kaya...
So, linawin lang namin, hindi pa siya pwede sa general relief. Kasi they're saying marijuana is effective.
Sakit ang ulo.
Sa pain
killer. Hindi pwede yun. Hindi pwede yun. For ano lang, compassionate use. Halimbawa, yung mga may terminal illness, yung mga rare disease, yung may rare illness, para lang... for the peace of mind ng patient at saka ng kanilang mga loved ones.
So, para, is there a proposal to include yung general pain relief
hindi,
purpose?
Wala. Kasi yun nga yung sabi nila, yung oil papahid daw.
Yan nga, dito.
Oh, yung mga ganon. Hindi pa, wala pa yan. Hindi considered compassionate use yan eh.
So, I'm not that familiar kasi with the varieties of the medical use of marijuana or marijuana extracts. Yung sinasabi na sa ibang bansa like in the States na may medical marijuana na pwedeng gamitin for general general well-being, iba 'yun.
Iba 'yun, baka that's another term for recreational.
Hindi kasi meron na tayong mental health law eh. Pwede bang i-apply yan for mental health distress?
Hindi, yung ano yan eh, yung yun nga sa for compassionate use, yun ang key dun eh. Kung halimbawa yung may terminal illness siya, yun ang hinihingi ng patiente kasi
sa cancer daw, it
masakit,
works.
To relieve the pain for cancer
patient. So, sa ganyan pwede?
It's pain management.
Diba, that can be, can be considered as compassionate use. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned there was some resistance within the board. Saan ang galing yan?
Remember, the board is several agency kami, including the Department of Health.
So, saan ang gagaling yung resistance?
For that particular issue, sila ang expert dyan eh. Sila yung mga doktor eh, not us, we're not doctors eh. So, we defer to the comment, to the recommendation, to the findings, scientific findings, ng mga expert na to. So, we support them kung ano yung findings nila, kung ano yung recommendation nila. Eh, yun nga, not only that, yung sa Department of Health natin, yung kanilang research office, and we also consulted yung mga Philippine Medical Association. So sila, according to them, there are other medicine naman which can, na available,
Parang ayaw na ibang doktor.
Which can provide yung the same relief and effect kesa doon sa...
ano yung main concern? The people who were resisting, ano yung main concern nila?
Isa doon yung especially sa law enforcement yung law enforcement side kasi nga it will yung cultivation actually yung ibang we are seeing yung takbo nung yung move na yan eh. So medical marijuana and then it will be the gateway for recreational use. And then they're talking already about cultivation and manufacturing.
So yun bang concern nila?
So isa yan sa concern natin na it will be very difficult to monitor and to enforce yung especially on the cultivation. Kasi ngayon pa lang hindi nga illegal na nga pero we can see na we see uprooting and burning of marijuana.
Parang it's a foot places. In the door.
Yes.
Sir, would it be fair to say that yung may pinaka-concern dun sa move na to would be from the security sector?
Security sector.
Or health.
And health sector also. Kasi what they're saying is we recognize na there might be a relief or temporary or immediate relief dun sa gamot. Psychological, basically. But yung long-term effect. Yung World Health Organization, actually, hindi pa sila firm dun sa pag-recommend dyan eh. Yung 0.1% ng CBD, yun yung kineri nga ng US FDA. The World Health Organization is recommending to increase the threshold to 0.2. So hindi inaksyonan ng United Nations Office on Drugs. Kasi siguro mga study pa nila. And we're just following yung 0.1%.
So are you saying hindi pa sigurado na ma-aprubahan to? Because there's still some discussion.
Basically, during the last meeting, na trace out na yung mga yung mga concern. Most I think it will go smoothly.
Okay.